Sean Cooper making the way to his cage for his inaugural professional mixed martial arts fight. 7-2 as an amateur, had a pretty solid record fighting out of Absolute Combat Club. Representing Dryden, Michigan, TXC fans, no strangers to AKC and the work ethic and quality athletes they bring to this cage.
His opponent making his way to the cage, fighting out of the blue corner. Put your hands together for Jacob Butler.
Jacob Butler making his way to the cage, fighting out of Big Rapids. Fighting out of Chad Coons' gym, 1-1 record. Looking to move to 2-1. Nobody wants to be a 500 fighter early in their career. No, nobody wants to be a 500 fighter ever in their career.
Fight fans, this fight is brought to you by Defiant Industries. Make sure you check them out on the far corner there. They have all your MMA needs. To my right, fighting out of the red corner, he weighed 144 pounds, stands 5'7" tall, making his debut in the cage tonight. He represents Absolute Combat Club and is trained by none other than Steve Lowe out of Dryden, Michigan. Put your hands together for Sean Cooper. To my left, fighting out of the blue corner, he weighed 144.8 pounds, stands 5'6" tall. He comes to us with a pro record of 1-1. As an amateur, he was 20-1. He represents Coon MMA and trained by Chad Coon out of Big Rapids, Michigan. Put your hands together for Jacob, the Asian Persuasion. Your referee in charge is Doug Gallegos.
All right, fight fans, about to get started here. Sean Cooper fighting out of the red corner. Blue and white Venom compression shorts. Jacob Butler fighting out of the blue corner, wearing the black kickboxing shorts. Third man in the cage, Doug Gallegos, getting us underway here. Early on, I really like Sean Cooper's footwork.
He keeps a wide base. He's moving around. You want to keep your foot on the outside, as you can see, you know, Jacob coming in as a southpaw.
Big head kick.
On Jacob Butler. But, you know, I don't think it carried that much weight. I think he wasn't even expecting to land it.
No, and then he followed it right in. Looking for the lateral drop was Jacob Butler. Almost got himself in trouble. Now getting himself in trouble. Going the other way, Sean Cooper. And these guys wisely deciding to separate and reset. Kira, that could have been disastrous for either of them at that point.
You know, Jacob trying to throw some kicks back, distract him, but, you know, Sean Cooper just relentlessly looking for that head kick. You know, you have success with it, and as soon as he sees that Jacob Butler's right hand drops, he goes for that head kick.
You know, and what I like also is that he's throwing big kicks with both legs. He's throwing it off the lead.
He just drops his hand to his waist. I mean, that's setting yourself up for an overhand right. There is an overhand right again. Oh, and then he follows up with a straight right down the pipe, which really damaged Sean Cooper.
And you could tell Sean Cooper was rocked because he immediately went to default mode, which is wrestling for him. Got to be careful. He doesn't get himself submitted standing up. There's little that's more embarrassing than to get choked on the side of the cage while you're still on your feet.
Look at the size of the legs of Jacob Butler, you know. But he uses his hands so well, you wouldn't think that he has that mass like a wrestler.
Now, Sean needs to get his hips down and forward and get some of his height back.
I'm just wondering if he's a little stymied right now because he got hit with that overhand right and the straight right. You know, Jacob Butler has a tendency to switch up his feet, so you never know what haymakers come in your way.
And again, big choke here from the underside. Got to be careful. He's defending it a little too late. Kira, now he's trying to hook and drive it to the ground. The head popping out there.
Oh, backing up and still throws a head kick. Oh, man, he left himself wide open when he went for that kick.
Yeah, well, you know, he went for the Hollywood kick there, got himself countered, dropped to the mat, and now he's got about a 160-pound suitcase on his back there.
Suitcase.
Fighting the choke here, doing a good job of keeping on the gloved hand, not in really any kind of danger from this choke. And able to get his wind back around him. Jacob's got to be careful about how he leaves those hooks. Got him dangling way too low. That's a recipe for disaster.
You know, Jacob.
Sean, go ahead. No, Sean has just stopped defending that choke now.
Yeah,
and there's
he
a tap.
Definitely didn't even look to push up on the elbow. He did nothing to defend it.
It's almost like he threw in the towel. And I'll tell you what, he absolutely got rocked several times. But he tried that big spinning heel hook, spinning hook kick, and just ate heavy, heavy leather that dropped him to the mat. Absolutely overwhelmed on his feet, overwhelmed on the ground. It's back to the drawing board for Sean Cooper. Jacob Butler moving to 2-1, and Sean Cooper in the most undesirable position of 0-1. Starting record here in the pro ranks. Wasting no time, let's get into the cage. Kara, KO Rowe with your official TXC decision.
All right, fight fans, your winner with 2 minutes and 47 seconds in the first round by rear naked choke. Give it up for Jacob, the Blazing Persuasion Butler. All right, Jacob, congratulations. You know, we had a chance to see you in the cage last time. What have you been doing differently? You came out full force.
I was just more dedicated. Making that transition from amateur to pro, you have to really step it up.
Now, are you surprised he survived? Like, you threw an overhand right, a straight right here, back to back. Are you surprised that he survived that?
I'm surprised I did that, because that's not very smart.
No, that was a great move. And talk to me a little bit about that head kick we saw early on. Did that rock you at all? Because you seemed to come back very quickly.
Just the first throw jitters. I love them. I gotta eat them. Best shot for the worst.
So talk to me about this first round, and how do you feel about this fight?
It was all right. Once again, I feel I could always better my performance.
All right, is there anyone that you have to thank that made you ready for this W tonight?
Of course, my buddy Mark Bongard, he's always pushing me. We're in the gym 2 times a day, a 24-hour gym, so it's whenever.
All right, it's always a pleasure to watch you fight, Jacob.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
All right, once again, Jacob Butler, y'all.
did you know that the announcer for tonight actually went out for Hammond?
Like four times.
I'm kidding. Not.
Here we go with the replay here. You can watch Sean doing a good job fighting that choke. And then he just sort of throws in the towel and lets it slide in deep. And you can see him just waiting for the tap to come. Trying to make a good show of it there before throwing in the towel. But why he got off that hand, he probably couldn't even tell you right now.
Let's welcome up our Patino Diet ladies and our Players Club ladies, please. Fans, this next fight is brought to you by Defiant Injury. Make sure you check them out over on the corner. They have a lot of specials tonight. Defiant Industries. Next up, making their way to the cage, fighting under the red corner. Put your hands together for Rich Stafford.
All right, fight fans, Rich Stafford making his way to this TXC cage. Professional record of 2-3, fighting out of Jenison. Triumph MMA's real strong wrestling background. Having a little trouble getting himself acclimated, getting punched in the head here. See if he can't right the ship, get it back up to 500, get moving forward. Once again, for those of you at home, we got 43 cage girls in the cage there. We got people from all over the globe watching, and apparently the NSA and other such organizations and bodies of chicanery and spying peeking in on the commentary tonight, so we're very flattered as always. Long past the time where I worry about putting my foot in my mouth. Can't decide if gold or peach is my new favorite color, at least for the next hour and a half. Always concerned about a fighter that comes out to the cage with Vanilla Ice as his walkout music.
And his opponent making his way to the cage, fighting out of the blue corner. Put your hands together for Tommy Bagnasco.
No stranger to this TXC cage as an amateur and as a 3-1 professional fighter. Tommy Bagnasco making his way down to the cage, picking his own name. Feel free to hate me. I like calling him the Big Nasty because when he puts it on you, it is on tight. Groundwork specialist who's straightening his hands out, throwing some big kicks, letting the leather fly. Win or lose, always exciting to watch. As we move deeper into this card, get into the deeper records and the deeper water, this is what I always look forward to watching.
All right, fight fans, here we go. This fight is brought to you by CaveRadioBroadcasting.com, Defiant Industries, and PatinoDiet.com. To my right, fighting out of the red corner, he weighed 146.8 pounds and stands 6 feet tall. He comes to us with 5 professional fights. He represents Triumph MMA. He is trained by Sean Desai and Bud Wright. Out of Jenison, Michigan, put your hands together for Rich Roughneck Stafford! And to my left, fighting out of the blue corner, he weighed 149 pounds, stands 6 feet tall. He comes to us with a record of 3 wins, 1 loss. He trains out of MASH Gym in Redford. He's trained by Todd Alley, Don Richard, and Main Team. He also represents Wild Lake. Put your hands together for Tommy. Feel free to hate on me, Bagnasco!
All right, fight fans, this fight about to get underway. Rich Roughneck Stafford fighting out of the red corner. White trimmed in black Venom shorts. Tommy, the Big Nasty Bagnasco.
You went back to the old school.
I cannot get into that new nickname, and a guy shouldn't be allowed to give himself his own nickname anyway.
You know, Tommy's got to be careful because he's moving to the left. You know, he's got to get his foot on the outside and take a look at what he's getting back from Rich Stafford.
Well, Rich Stafford holding his hands up there with his fingers wide open, having to close his hands before he throws every punch and telegraphing him. Here, Tommy looking to throw those kicks again.
It changes back to an orthodox position, mixing things up.
Tommy still looks like he's trying to fly away with his elbows there, though.
Yeah, and he's got to get his chin down. That's the other thing. And then he throws that jab and loses his right hand.
And he's got to be careful throwing those kicks. Those hands are coming down like they did a long time ago for him.
They both seem really hesitant with these kicks. Like, they're not really throwing them with, you know, full power. They're kind of just feeling each other out right now.
Well, those last two kicks are Rich Stafford's not very effective, but a lot of effect. Oh,
a
nice.
Spinning back fist, and then he follows up.
Kara.
It's a great follow-up. Oh, Rich Stafford comes in with that 1-2, and he, you know, just landed it, but not solid. You know, and those big looping haymakers are really hard to see. They're really hard to defend against. That's why you got to keep your hands up. Tommy switching back again, and one of them have to obtain a foot position because that's the only way you can get that power shot off from the back.
Well, both of these guys just standing up square, too. Not a lot
of
movement.
Oh, man, and he's just
–
Stafford's obviously strategy is just go flying in with that 1-2.
Well, Tommy back in his wheelhouse. He loves to be on the ground.
Yeah, and, I mean, he tries to play the stand-up game just to get more experience at it, but this is where he likes to be, is definitely on his back.
Stafford's got good downward hip pressure, though, nice and heavy right now. Got to be careful, though. Tommy looking to slide that left knee through and set up the triangle. Stafford again trying to step over there. Tommy having none of it. It's hard to make that transition when a guy's got full mobility, and if you don't pin his shoulders
right
up against the side of the cage and or put some downward pressure on the hips, you're never going to get around the corner there. Now, the thing that's going to keep Stafford safe, that right butterfly hook of Tommy's, is a sweep to the left, and the left is the cage, so Stafford's going to be able to just sit there
some
and ride
double
it out.
Hits there, the elbows and then the head smashing against the floor. This is Tommy's got to do something about that to nullify this.
Well, he needs to get back to his feet and reset at this point. He's tried to set up a couple of submission attempts from the bottom, and he's gotten pounded every time, Kara.
You know,
I'll tell you what, Stafford's letting him off the hook, though, letting him play on the side like that, though. If he just turns him to the side of the cage, slowly working his way into his own corner, though.
Yeah, I was going to say, you'd think his corner would be giving him that advice.
Well, one of his corner men is recording the fight on his camera phone.
Steve,
all right, it's
I
time.
I love how you always call out the corners.
Well, it's time to step up. I mean, this is not amateur fighting
right
anymore. It's a professional fight. And you're in the corner. I mean, they make you pay $25 for a license, for God's sake. Act like a pro. I'm not hating. I mean, he's doing his fighter a huge disservice right now. He's getting no advice from his corner, and
just,
he should be able to end this
like
fight here
fans
with as lackadaisical as Tommy is from the bottom. And you know, you can't give Tommy Bagnasco any opportunity.
No.
You give him any wiggle room and his hand's going in the air.
I hope he's been working his jits as much because, you know, he's come in from the amateurs as the solid jits. But then if you're focusing a lot on the stand-up, you don't want to lose what you already have.
You know, well, if Rich Stafford can hear me, he needs to get some a little more down pressure on those hips and start bringing heavy leather right now. And Tommy has to be careful because Doug Gallegos is very close to this action, and he's looking for a reason to get in there and separate them. He's seen Tommy take enough.
Well, Tommy's trying to push himself off the cage, and he got far for a minute, and then Rich brought him back.
Again, now see, every time Rich pulls his hips back, he takes that pressure off. Tommy needs to start finding some space from there. Instead, he's just getting pounded with that left elbow. This first round turning into a very one-sided round, Kara Rowe.
Yeah, definitely. I mean,
right now, Tommy making some separation.
And he needs to just keep pushing himself back and get, oh. You know, he kind of took a stalemate there for a second and let Rich climb back on top of him.
Well, you know what? He baited Rich a little bit. He could have taken that time to get Rich nice and long as he came back in and looked to set up a sweep or even a submission attempt. Right now he's just trying not to get hit as we come into the closing seconds of this first round, Kara. Unless something really weird happens, we are going to get to the second round. But this definitely a one-sided endeavor.
Yeah, Tommy definitely got to do something different because, you know, I think he gets really confident when he's on his back, but he hasn't been able to do anything with Rich Stafford, so he's got to change up this game plan.
All right, first round's in the books. And, you know, Tommy is going to get to go to the second round, but at this point, If this is a one-round fight, he's done. It's
yeah,
over.
Yeah, I mean, it's good to see Don Richard jump in that corner, though, because that's where he was struggling, is on the ground, and Don's got to give him some advice, change things up a little bit. See, they've got a battle for foot position. When they're in there, they're standing toe-to-toe. They're just looking at each other and trying these. A lot of their kicks have just been kind of lazy, just kind of measuring.
And they're throwing their hands and either moving straight or waiting to see, did I do anything with this? And they're eating a big counter shot. And Tommy got clipped a couple of times on that last exchange they went to the ground.
The great thing with the stand-up for Rich is he's committed with that 1-2, and he's connected. And if he hasn't connected, it was just shy of connection. So And Tommy's got to watch that. You cannot just stand in front of him. You can't go straight back because he's coming in with that 1-2, and he throws it really nice down the pipe.
And that big overhand, that windmill that he's obviously spent a lot of time working on because he just unleashes that thing. All that's got to do is slip through, and it's lights out.
I
know you hate that.
I hate it because it's not even something. I couldn't even practice that. It's because it's so wrong. Once you get so far, you got to snatch your arm back because to go all the way through puts you in a terrible defensive position.
He came out to vanilla ice, so maybe that's...
Well, they do look similar. Both of their chins high in the air, and Tommy back out with those elbows. I mean, obviously just goes right back to what he knows.
And he's following that sort of jabbing hook straight in.
See,
and
Tommy's
got to
be careful because when he turns orthodox, if he doesn't practice that as much, you don't know defensively, you can't react as quickly.
Well, that right slipped in, but there wasn't much behind it.
That Rich went for that commitment with that 1-2 again.
And this time Rich looking to set up a shot and then bailing on it, now finding himself in a lot of trouble. Tommy on the side of the cage with a front headlock, giving it up, getting himself body locked here.
Well, when they're in the center of the cage, Rich puts his head down before he throws that 1-2, and he's got to look to see where his target is.
Well, he's got to hope Tommy doesn't figure it out and bring up a leg or an uppercut also. Answers with a bolo, and he'll wind up on his back.
Oh, the bolo. What do you know about the bolo, Steve?
I don't know much about boxing. You know that. I didn't grow up beside a 9-inch color or a black and white television with my grandfather.
With your grandpa watching every weekend?
Yeah, absolutely. You make me tell the story every time, and then you mock me for it.
Oh, a nice knee up the center. Tommy lands on Rich.
Well, both of these guys fighting with the underhook and the body lock, but their hands winding up in the center of the back, which really is no man's land. It's very difficult to be effective with the body lock from there.
You
have to get the hands high or very low.
Rich landing a knee to the inside of Tommy's leg, and Tommy answered with a knee to the body.
This round not quite as lopsided as the first round.
But then that can change very quickly depending on where Tommy ends up at the end of this.
Again, see how the hands are in the center of the back there? He needs to get them high, get them low, but in the middle is no man's land, and it's really tough to be effective from that position. It's very easy for Tommy to defend that.
It seems like Tommy is just processing stuff. Like, he's not really reacting. He's trying to think his way through too much of it.
Stafford doing a good job grinding with that head also. Now looking for a nice little outside.
Drags
sort of a leg
down.
Sweep there. Modified dirty little judo throw. Nice sweep. Bagnasco taking the back.
Gosh.
Into a rear naked and a turn. I told you cannot give him any wiggle
room.
What
a turn of events, man. What a turn of events. Because, you know, it was looking like Tommy was in danger zone all over again. And look at turning that into the W for him in the second round.
And
by
Stafford
rear naked.
With a look of disbelief and disgust on his face. But there is enough film on Tommy Bagnasco. You cannot give him any wiggle room or his hand will go in the air. And it didn't take but a split second for him to transition from that blown sweep as Stafford went belly down right onto the back of Rich Stafford. And that was it, folks. That choke was in deep on hard, and it was lights out. Tommy Bagnasco turning lemons into lemonade, getting beat up for most of that first round. Here we go. Watch this here. Works the sweep. Stafford tried to fight back to his feet, leaves his neck to his knees, his neck exposed.
All right, fight fans, your winner with 2 minutes and 28 seconds in the second round by rear naked choke. Give it up for Tommy. Feel free to hate on me, Bagnasco.
Just a little bit of advice for Tommy. Don't use your head as to block punches. Go back to the old nickname, brother. Kara, with your winner.
Dude, what are you doing to everyone out there, stressing them out like that? What a beautiful finish. What a turn of events. Talk to me about this fight, Tommy.
Well, I know. I've always been a slow starter. First round's never been my friend. More or less, like, I don't know. He got on top. I just couldn't seem to get him off. It was too slippery. But, hey, it worked to my advantage in round two.
Yeah, what was so elusive about him, and was it just the slipperiness? Because we know you're standing up, you do some great things, but we know when you're on your back, it's usually good night, Irene.
Yeah, more or less, it came down to the slipperiness. Like, I could not get a grip on his arm, on his leg, on anything. Like, I felt like he was just a big ball of Vaseline that first round, so I ate a lot of elbows, ate a lot of punches, but who gives a shit? Well, who cares, right? I'm here. I won. Woo!
I have to say, you know, our confidence went up a little bit. When we saw Don Richard come in, we were like, thank God he's got to talk to him about his ground game. What were your thoughts after that first round? Because you knew you didn't have it in the bank.
Oh, that first round, I more or less just threw out of the books the moment when that round ended. I was like, you know what? It's in the past. Who cares? Round two and three are mine.
What a great attitude. That's awesome, Tommy. Talk to me about this finish and how easily you finished that off.
He went to hip toss me. When he did, he turned too far. And like I said, the slipperiness came into play. I went right to his back, locked him in the short choke. Now, I don't want anyone to think I was being mean. I literally could not get my arms undone. He was laying on him, so I wasn't trying to choke him extra or anything like that.
Now, it sounds like you had this entire place screaming. Talk to me about here. Who's here to see you?
I got my friends, my family, my trainers, everyone that means something to me. Title boxing, I mean, I cannot thank my bosses, friends, family. I love all you guys. I mean, you guys are my world. You're the reason I'm in here. You're the reason I do it.
Anyone else you have to thank, Tommy?
Don Richards, Todd Lee, all the guys that trained with me at MASH Gym, all the guys that put the minutes in, extra time, coming in when they got their kids, they got snow days. They're all driving out there to work with me. I work with them. It's one love, and you know what? This is all worth it right here.
Congratulations, Tommy. What a turn of events.
Thank you, Tara. Love you guys. Hug it out.
All right, once again, Tommy.